in-ceiling speaker or Atmos firing speaker? What should you really buy to complete your Atmos home cinema experience? Hello everyone, my name is Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant or the home theater wale bhaiya. Been designing thousands of home cinema experiences since last 8 years, and while doing this, I have realized one thing, that if at all you are not equipped with the right information or the right knowledge, you can be taken for a ride when you are buying home theater systems, because people might sell you what they have and not necessarily what you need to have in your homes. So for that reason, make sure to enjoy this video, which will equip you with the knowledge of the right Atmos speaker for your home theater sound, so that you don't make the mistakes which others are doing. In-ceiling speaker or Atmos firing speaker. First of all, we have already discussed about what is Atmos, right? Why do we need to buy Atmos, or what is it that differentiates a Dolby Digital 5.1 to a Dolby Atmos 5.1.2? To those of you who still haven't checked that video, make sure to use the link above to check that video, wherein we have given enough knowledge to you so that you can make the decision of upgrading your system to a Dolby Atmos system for a great surround sound experience. Now, to achieve Atmos, obviously you need speaker or you need some sound coming from the top. So the reason why we have got these two speakers, A, you have an option of putting the speaker inside your false ceiling and it can give you the Atmos sound directly from the ceiling. The second option is this Atmos firing speaker, which can be kept on the floor standing speaker or on your bookshelf speakers in the front or in the rear, and they can throw the sound towards the ceiling and back, that sound further reflects from the ceiling and comes to your ears, and that's how you also get Atmos sound. Now, what honestly is the best solution of this? I know most of you have already chosen this, because for a simple reason, this is a hardwired speaker which is right in the ceiling above you. So obviously the sound that will come from this speaker is going to be much, much, much more better than what an Atmos firing speaker will be able to deliver. So who should really buy this Atmos firing speaker? Well, if at all your 5 wires have been already placed and you still want an Atmos experience, then this speaker is for you, so that you can keep it right on top of your floor standing or bookshelf speakers and can get the Atmos effect. But this works when you're sitting at a distance of around 10 to 12 feet from your TV or from the screen, because the reflection will be at a small angle. Also, the reflection will work only when the ceiling height is less than 9 feet. Yes, that is the bare minimum requirement to have this speaker used as an Atmos speaker. Similarly, if you are going to use it for your rear speakers, the distance between your ears and the rear speaker should not be more than 10 feet. Otherwise, the Atmos experience will not be delivered. So obviously the winner in terms of this is the ceiling speaker, and there are angled Atmos in-ceiling speaker as well available nowadays, which you can buy and you can angle them towards your ears for a better 3D surround sound experience. I'm not going to make this video very, very easy for you by telling you about only these two speakers. I've got something more. Now, to those of you who don't have the provision or the privilege to do the cabling and want to avoid these speakers, the Atmos firing speakers, what you really need to buy is that you need to buy a front height speaker. Now, this same speaker can be used as a front height or surround height speaker, and that speaker should be configured in your AVR settings as an Atmos speaker. Because if you do that, your sound experience will be much more better than the Atmos firing job done by this speaker. So what you do is basically you place the speaker vertically on a wall. You need to buy some wall mounts obviously for the speaker, and you mount them at a height of 10 feet, 9 feet, wherever your ceiling is. Mount the speaker over there, and this particular angle will throw the sound towards the sitting area. Similarly, if you're going to put it in your surrounds, you can do this in the surrounds as well if front is not possible for you. But I am sure that for those of you who have limitations of wiring, surround is not going to be an option. You will have to install this in the front area and make sure to have small cables go only up to the ceiling in the front wall or front TV unit, and this particular speaker can do a great job of Atmos as well. So the same Atmos firing speaker can be used for front height because of the angle that this surface has been already given. And that angle is one of the best gifts that you will get by using the speaker as a front height or a surround height than using this as an Atmos firing speaker. Similarly, for those of you who do not have false ceiling, okay, and want to avoid this, or if you are able to avoid this speaker by actually installing some good wall mount speakers, try to use the same in the ceiling and use them for Atmos. Because obviously a ceiling speaker's output, particularly these kind of small ceiling speakers output, is not going to be more than 50-60 watts or maximum 80 watts. Whereas if you buy a wall mount or a ceiling mount, you know, big speaker, which is equal to the cost of this, but yet high in terms of power, that is, we are talking about more than 100 watts of power. And those speakers will obviously give you much more better Atmos effect than what these speakers would do. That's why when you visit cinema halls, you don't see that these people, though they giving you ceiling speakers, you actually see the speakers. The speakers are same what they have used in the surround. Only thing is they have given them in the ceiling and given an angle towards the sitting area. So I hope that this video helps you make better decision about what sort of ceiling speaker or Atmos speaker you need to really buy for your 3D surround sound experience. And to those of you who still have queries, make sure to use our T20 service, which is there in the description, wherein you and I can talk for 20 minutes and I can help you make you decide the right home cinema systems. I can help you save thousands of rupees of yours by telling you the right price that you need to buy this system at. And to those of you who need that push or who need that assurance that what they're buying is right or wrong, then this T20 service is for these three people. So if you fall amongst those, make sure to use that service. Also, to those of you who want a one-to-one wherein I help you with your layout, with design, the configuration and everything, check out the Home Run service and you can avail these services wherein I'll be available for you. And I'll continue the same job of helping each one of you with better home cinema experiences. And this knowledge, as I promised at the start of the video, is going to help each one of you make better, well-informed and correct decisions, and is going to be used as an ammunition so that nobody takes you for a ride and you buy what is right for you and your home theater experience. Thank you once again. I, Tanmay Mehta, your home theater wale bhaiya, will see you all in my next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe.